After we have fetched the data and have selected the data we want, the next part involves processing them. Here, one tool is the king, the sort command. Sort is so useful that those who have implemented it have gone to amazing lengths in order to make it work efficiently with huge amounts of data. Let me explain. To sort data swiftly, we need to load it into main memory, RAM. The RAM we have can often be quite smaller than the amount of data we want to sort. As a result, if the whole data cannot fit into memory, sort will load into memory as much data as possible, sort it, save it to disk into an intermediate file, and then start another cycle. In the end, it can efficiently merge sort those files into the result we are after. This is done by looking just at the topmost line of each intermediate file. You might think this could work with an arbitrary large number of intermediate files, thus allowing us to sort any amount of data. Actually, there's another limit that can be reached. If we wanted to sort terabytes of data, we might end up with thousands of temporary files. However, most operating systems have a limit on the number of files that can be simultaneously open. Usually, at most 1,000 files can be opened at once. Cunningly, the sort command has special code so that when it reaches the maximum open file limit, it merges the generated intermediate files into a new intermediate file and then recursively applies the same merging algorithm until it has merged the thousands of temporary files into the result that we are after. The great efforts programmers have put into making sort handle efficiently any amount of data you throw at it demonstrate its power and usefulness. Don't forget to try out the commands we'll be examining on your own shell. I send and receive tons of emails every day. To demonstrate how we can process data, let's analyze the dates of the emails I send. First, I use grep to select the date fields of all my sent emails.
Supposing I have stored my sent emails dates to a file named dates, let's see what this file looks like. It contains the day of the week, the actual date, the day of month, month, year, the time, and the corresponding time zone. Counting the file's lines, we see that it includes more than 20,000 records.
Let's now clean the data.
Sorting the dates file and looking at the first few lines, we notice that some of them do not contain an actual date. Instead, they contain the word date followed by a colon and something else. To remove this noise, I run grep on this file with a minus V option to get all records but the ones containing date. Sorting the cleaned file and looking at the beginning, we verify that there are only actual dates now. Records following the noise pattern were removed. Now, we can safely rename dates.clean to dates, replacing its previous contents and continue our processing.
We can sort our data by various fields, keys that the sort command will use.
Sorts minus K option allows us to sort the output based on the specified fields, keys. By default, fields are space separated. Here, I specify to sort by the second field, the day of the month. As expected, the output records start from the first day of the month. Then, they are sorted based on the subsequent fields, month, year, and so on. Similarly, to sort first by the second field, the day of the month, and then by the first field, the day of the week, I specify minus k 2,2 to start and end at the second field, and then minus k 1,1 to sort by the first field. We can also sort by a field's segment, specifying the start and end character positions with a decimal point after the field number. For example, to sort dates by the time minutes, I specify the fifth and sixth characters of the fifth field. Be careful here. If none of the options minus T or minus B are in effect, with T we specify the field separator as we'll see next, while with B we ignore leading blanks, characters in a field are counted from the beginning of the preceding white space. That's why we specify the 5th and 6th characters here instead of the 4th and 5th ones.
Sort offers a reverse option which will sort our data not in the default ascending order, so 1, 2, 3, 4, but in the descending one, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This order is often the most useful.
To see an example, let's first sort dates by the 4th field, the year. In this way, records appear in a yearly ascending order. To reverse the order and have a descending one, we add the R option to sort after the field number. R stands for reverse. Have a look at the output. Now, the latest year appears first, while the earliest comes last.
The sort command also knows about months. This allows us to sort January, February, March, April, and so on in chronological order.
Let's first try to sort dates by the 3rd field, the month, using sort's default ordering. We see that April comes first because the order is alphabetical rather than chronological. To have a monthly chronological order, we specify the M option after the field number. In this way, January appears first, then comes February, March, and so on. Notice how the days of the month are also sorted alphabetically instead of numerically. 1 is followed by 10, 12, 13, and after 19 comes 2, 20, and so on. To sort the days in numerical order, we specify the N option after the field number. So, here I first sort chronologically by month, and then numerically by the day of the month. As a result, 1 comes first, then comes 2, 3, 4, and so on.
When our input fields are not space-separated, we can use the minus T option in order to specify the field separation character.
Let's work on the familiar password file with the user's details. As we can see, its fields are colon-separated rather than space-separated, which is sort's default field separator. Consequently, to sort this file numerically by the 4th field, which is a numerical group identifier, I specify the colon separator with the T option, and then the field number with minus K for N.
Quite often, we sort lines to bring the identical ones together, and then we pipe the output to the unique command in order to keep each line only once. The sort command offers the minus U unique option to do the same thing more efficiently.
Back to the dates example, counting its lines, we saw that it contains around 21,000 dates. To find the unique dates, I sort them, pipe them to unique, and counting them again, we see that the unique dates are about 20,900. To avoid the intermediate unique step, we can run sort minus U on dates, which outputs a unique instance of each record. In this way, we get the same results as before, but more efficiently.
The sort command can also merge already sorted files very efficiently. This offers us the so-called merge sort algorithm.
Let's first look at another action that sort can do very efficiently. Check whether a file is sorted. To do that, I create a sorted version of dates. Then, I run sort minus capital C on dates, which checks whether a file is sorted. If that is true, I echo sorted. As expected, no output is produced because days is not sorted. On the other hand, running the same command on the sorted file, we get sorted because the file is actually sorted. Now, let's measure how long it takes to sort two large files. Here, I sort two instances of dates and use the time command to determine the time's execution duration. Sorting them takes around half a second, as we can see. If I create a sorted version of dates and time again how long it takes to merge two instances of this file into a new sorted one using the minus M option of sort, we see that it takes a tenth of the previous reported time. This is much faster. The reason this happens is because in the second case, sort only looks at each file's top record, outputs the first in order, and repeats the same procedure on the next record pairs.
I often find it useful to sort numbers that are followed by a metric suffix, such as KB, MB, GB, and so on. For example, when I use the du command to list the size of various directories, the sort command can sort them correctly with a special option.
To see an example, I first run du-h on the current directory, which outputs the disk usage in a human-readable format, kilobytes, megabytes, gigabytes, and so on. Then, piping the output to sort, I sort the usage numbers in a reverse numerical order with the minus r option and output them again in a human-readable format with the equivalent h option to sort. As we can see, the current directory contains around 3 gigabytes, out of which around 2 are consumed by lib, another one by share, and so on.
This concludes our unit on processing data by sorting. Stay with us.